Right into our WDSU First Warning Weather Impact Day. We've already got flood advisories, flood watches in effect. Flood advisory for the New Orleans Metro, and that's where we're going to start after we see the flood watch. A couple of additions have been made. Coastal Mississippi, St. Tammany Parish, and Southern Tangipahoa Parish. Yesterday it was just for the South Shore. Now we've got a few more, a little farther north. Even if you're not in those parishes included or counties in Mississippi, you still got the potential for locally heavy rain the next couple of days as well. Here's a look at the bigger picture where we got the storms. That's the flood advisory. This is all of the New Orleans Metro, at least on the East Bank. We don't see the West Bank in there just yet. One wave of rain has just moved through, holding on to steady rain at the airport. Heaviest downpours now to Terrio to Raceland. Bayou Buff to Choctaw getting the heavier rain, and even a couple of lightning strikes and some thunder boomers that are there. Rudock, a couple of showers passing through off the Lake Maurepas. Next round of rain from Lake Catherine, Chefman Tour. This, if it has a track coming in here in New Orleans, could give us a bout of heavier rain, increase the rain totals, and has the potential to upgrade that to a flash flood warning. So we're going to watch that real quick. Rainfall totals estimates over the past 12 hours from Doppler radar, 1, 2.5 to even seen some areas nearly 3 inches of rain. Look at all the storms that still extend into the Gulf. Lower Plaquemines, can't think about the coast too. You're getting quite the storms too. So generally speaking, the forecast data has been consistent as we get in the next 3 hours or so from here, that rain activity starts to fade after sunset. So you can see that outlook up till 10 shows we get a little break. Then we got more overnight storm potential and maybe waking up to more storms as we're trying to get around into Thursday morning. Temperature's not too bad. We'll be into the 70s, so it's still warm, mild, and humid, depending on how you look at it. Have the rain gear. Make sure you got the kids ready to go too. Save yourself some time. Just prepare for all of it here tonight, right? Here's a look at the storm projection in the 11 o'clock on Thursday. And let me in on a little bit of a secret here to the forecast data. This is just a guideline here for us. A lot of times when there's cold fronts north and I see a mass of storms, I can track in time that, show you exactly when it's here. But in this situation, storms can kind of blow up just on their own, wherever they want to form. The takeaway is we will get rain Thursday, continuing into Friday. It's going to hold temperatures down. We're only looking for highs around 80 to maybe 84 coming into Thursday. And breezy. Southeast winds 10 to 20 extend small craft advisories. Coastal flood advisories too, pushing on some water on shore. So look out for the breezy conditions and it will storm. I've got 100% chances the next 2 days. Not until we're getting into Saturday does a front try to come through and try to shut off that rain from north to south. But high-res forecasts want to show in some cases 7.5 inches of rain. Top temps into Friday, maybe only upper 70s in the North Shore. Maybe only to around 82. That's almost 10 degrees below average. Now here's the setup for the weekend though. We are going to be right behind this front that kind of fades and stalls as we typically find this time of the year. Some drier air is going to come in and some strong gusty winds. Right now, I've added back in cloud cover for St. Sunday and I have a little bit of rain hanging on to Saturday. But right now there's the chance we can get some more sunshine to pop out here for the game on Sunday. But right now I'm going to go cloudy. If we get more sunshine, that's just a bonus forecast. Here's the bigger picture for the tropics. Whoa, look at all these areas, a new one that's been added, but that's going to be a system that doesn't have any chance of doing anything for anyone. Our watch is still going to be the tropical wave in the Caribbean. By the time we get to next week, the possibility it comes out Bay of Campeche starts to get some organization, but it's going to interact with that front that drops through this weekend. So the going forecasts have that energy kind of tearing the system apart and keeping it away from us. But we'll continue to track it. WDSU First Warning Weather, 7 days, stormy days, impact days, flood watches. Things start to at least dry out over the weekend. Winds pick up, lower humidity drops in. We're just going to hope for a little more sun.